Hey everyone, so in my last video when I talked about endgame bow builds, I mentioned the Berserk build and I said that it was the most comfortable and one of the best builds right now for bow. However, it can be a bit scary if you're not used to it because it has some level of health drain. So I wanted to make a video to show you how to use this build properly and how to make the most out of it. First off, we're gonna be using the full Chaos Gormagala armor set. And it has two unique skills. The first one is Strife and the second one is Berserk. Those two skills go together, so I'm gonna explain both and we're gonna start with Strife. We're gonna be using level 3 on this build, so I'm only gonna talk about that, but Strife has two levels of activations. If you have a little bit of red health or less than 60% of your total health, you will get 10% affinity and 15% element. However, the real benefit of Strife is if you have more than 60% of your health as red. In that case, you get 20% affinity, 20% element, but most importantly, you have infinite stamina. And that's where Strife has synergy with Berserk. Berserk does nothing on the red scroll, but when you swap to the blue scroll, like you can see on the screen, it transforms all of your health to red health. As long as you have enough health, this will instantly proc Strife 3, giving you all the bonuses, including the infinite stamina. On top of that, as long as you are on the blue scroll, you are completely invulnerable to damage. So if you get hit by a monster, you will not lose any health. However, there is a catch. While you are on the blue scroll, you will lose your health slowly. If your health gets to zero, you will die. And when you get hit by a monster, the drain speed will increase. However, you can reset the drain speed very easily by switching to the red scroll for a few seconds and then switching back to the blue scroll. So the goal of this video is going to be to teach you how to manage the drain efficiently and how to optimize Berserk and play it as best as possible. So this video is going to be in two steps. The first step is going to be how to survive the drain, so that's going to be the basics of Berserk. And the second step is going to be to optimize the uptime and the efficiency of the build. And just as a quick reminder, this is the build that I showed in my last video, and this is the build that we're gonna be using for this video also. So in my last video, I called Berserk the safest build you can have, but I know a lot of people are scared about the health drain, which I understand. However, there are a lot of ways to manage the health drain. The biggest one is having Kushala Blessing 3, which gives you constant health regen. If you pair that with an immunizer, it will almost entirely nullify the base drain. And finally, if you can eat for super recovery Dango level 4, along with Kushala Blessing and immunizer, this will entirely and completely nullify the health drain. Now on top of those, you can add other options. Blood Rite is pretty nice if you can slot it in. I would only have it at level 1 though, more is not that useful. Recovery Up is very expensive, it increased the effect of Kushala Blessing, so it's nice, but it's very expensive to slot in, so I would not slot that in. Gourmet Fish also gives you a nice health regen, which stacks with the rest, but it only lasts for 90 seconds, so I personally don't use it, but if you want to use it, you can. Also, if you have buddies and followers that can heal you, those are very, very strong healing. Especially if you can have a cat with the healing clover bats. We're gonna talk about those in a little bit. This is a very strong skill, so I would suggest you use those. So those are your healing options, but what happens when you get hit? So when you get hit, the drain is going to speed up. Depending on the strength of the attack, the drain is going to speed up by a lot or by a little bit. A small bite will drain a little bit more, and a big strong attack will increase the speed of the drain a lot. If you are new to Berserk, I would suggest that every time you get hit, you swap to the red scroll, you heal, and then you swap back to the blue scroll. Switching to the red scroll for a few seconds will reset the drain speed, so it's gonna go back to the base drain speed. However, remember that on the red scroll, you are not invulnerable. So when you swap, make sure that it's safe and that you're not gonna get hit. If you get hit a lot, it will feel like you're swapping in and out of the blue scroll very often, which can be an inconvenience. But first of all, we're gonna talk about that in the next part of the video. And second of all, remember that in endgame with bow, if you're fighting anomaly monsters or risen elders, you'd get one shot almost every time you get hit. So that's better than going back to camp. Before we move on to how to optimize this playstyle, let's quickly summarize the basics of playing Berserk. you want to be most of the time in the blue scroll, because that's when you have your damage buff, your infinite stamina, and that's also when you are invulnerable to damage. To stay in the blue scroll as long as possible, you must have some drain management skills. My recommendation is Kushala Blessing 3 along with Immunizer. If possible, you can add Super Recovery 4. All the other options are bonuses that you can add, but they are not necessary. If you happen to get hit, your drain speed will increase, and you want to swap to the red scroll, heal, and swap back to the blue scroll, and by then the drain speed will have reset. Now that was for the basic, the goal was to survive. Now let's talk about how to optimize Berserk. The biggest way you can optimize Berserk is to minimize the amount of time that you swap to the red scroll. So obviously the best way to not go back to the red scroll is to never get hit, but that's not the advice I'm gonna give you because that's not very realistic. There are only two reasons that you need to swap to the red scroll. One, you're going to die, so you need to swap to the red scroll to not die. And two, your health is going below 60% on the blue scroll, which means that you're losing strife and you're losing your infinite stamina. Losing your infinite stamina is very rough on this build because you have no stamina management skills, so your stamina will go away instantly. However, unless you get hit by a very strong attack, you do not have to swap to the red scroll every time. In Sunbreak, there are a lot of times when the monster is down, whether it's from a trip, a stun, a paralysis, an afflicted topple, a wyvern ride, there are a lot of occasions. There are a lot of times when you're going to get hit, but the drain is still going to be manageable for a while. Your health is still going to be above 60%. Look at this clip for example. I got hit, but the monster is going to be down soon, and I know that. So I wait for the monster to be down, and I swap to the red scroll, still do damage, so I don't lose damage uptime, and then when I'm out of stamina, I swap back to the blue scroll, and my drain has reset. Swapping to the red scroll during a topple is the most common way to reset your drain without wasting DPS. Now there are a few ways that you can maintain your health even with high drain. The easiest and probably the most common one is Blood Blight. When you're fighting afflicted monsters and they hit you, yes, the drain will be higher, but they also give you Blood Blight, which gives you a pretty high lifesteal on hit, which will help you combat the drain. The second one that is one of the most broken one is the healing Clover Bat that comes from your Palico secret skill. The healing Clover Bat, when you pick it up after your Palico creates them, gives you very, very strong health regen as long as you hit the monster, and it lasts for quite some time. On this clip, I have the healing Clover Bats, and I can tank the full Silver Rathalos afflicted Nova, so I have maximum drain and I still don't lose health. And here you can see that as long as you keep hitting the monster, the healing Clover Bat on the top of the screen will keep filling up and your health will just not go down. So if you have the healing Clover Bat active, you can just keep hitting the monster even with full drain and will just not lose health at all. And that's on top of your Palico and your followers healing, because they will keep healing you in the meantime also. One advice that I can give you at the start of the fight is to use the Felvin. The Felvin will boost your Palico's abilities and they can use them more often, and they're gonna have the healing Clover Bat a lot faster than if you don't use the Felvin. So between Blood Blight, the healing Clover Bats, the followers and buddies healing, and your natural healing skills, you can spend quite some time with high drain without dropping to low health. If you absolutely need to heal and you can't maintain the drain, there's still one thing you can do to not lose DPS uptime. As you can see on the screen, your buddies and followers will mostly heal you if you're low health, so one thing you can do is swap to the red scroll to cut your health in back, and instantly swap back to the blue scroll. Your followers will see that you have low health and heal you instantly. However, keep in mind that your followers and buddies have a cooldown on the healing, so be mindful of not using that strat all the time. Another thing that you can do to increase your DPS is to do a single power shot. Before Berserk, when we didn't have infinite stamina, we used double power shot a lot because it's very stamina friendly. But now that we have infinite stamina, we can just dash rapid power shot, dash rapid power shot. This is more DPS than doing a double power shot. There are still situations where you will do a double power shot, mostly due to timing, but if you're able to, a single power shot will be more DPS than two. But that's about it for the video. I know a lot of you guys were interested in Berserk, but we're a little bit worried about the health drain, so hopefully with this video, it seems a little less scary. As usual, if you have questions, please leave a comment, and I'll see you next time.